You know, I've been offered a bunch of free guitars, and I've played other ones over the years, but I like this one. It has all the history to it. When you all first started to come out to see us play, it didn't have any markings on it at all. Now it's got this hole up worn out in the back. There's one night playing the cellar where I got really mad and smashed my hand through the back of it. And somewhere along the way, I started getting autographs on it. And now to have, you know, George Jones's autograph there, that means so much to me. It always did, you know, but George Strait's on there. And Joe Walsh, that was a kind of drunken night. I was like, Joe, sell my guitar. I don't know how he fits in on here, but he's a really cool guy. And by the Willie Nelson hole, I got a little Willie Nelson autograph down there. Just, you know, just the bluegrassers are over here. It's part of who I am, so I would never want to trade it in. I'm always kind of trying to keep this thing propped up and still working. It's constantly splitting or cracking. But that or just my boots or the tour bus. I don't know, just who I am. I hold on to stuff. And so I wrote this song with a buddy of mine named Brett James, and I really, really liked it a lot. And I think it's probably my most personal song about who I am. We'll give it the old acoustic rendition. Truck. Some say that I should trade up now that I got some jangle in my pocket. But what they don't understand is it's the miles that make a man. I would trade that thing in for a rocket. What they don't know is my dad and me, we drove her out to Tennessee, and she's still here now he's gone. So I hold on. It's just an old beat-up box, six rusty strings across the top. It probably don't look like much to you. These dents and scratches in the wood, yeah, that's what makes it sound so good. To me, it's better than brand new. You see this here flat-top guitar's had my back in a million bars, singing every country song. So I hold. Tell you something.